President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. holds his very first cabinet meeting, where he was briefed on the country's economic situation. Pia Gutierrez now joins us with details. Pia, what more can you tell us?
Yes, Carmina, newly installed Marcos cabinet officials held their first meeting in Malacañang Tuesday morning, a few days after President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. was sworn into office. We have yet to get updates from Malacañang on how the meeting is going on, but the public was allowed to view via live stream the first few minutes of the meeting, which started very early, or a few minutes before 9 in the morning. Vice President Sara Duterte led the cabinet into prayer, where she asked for divine guidance to help new leaders make decisions that will be for the benefit of the country. During the meeting, President Marcos Jr. immediately called on his economic managers, particularly Finance Secretary Benjamin Jokno, NEDA Chief Arsenio Balisacan, and Banco Central ng Pilipinas Governor Felipe Medalla to brief the cabinet on the country's general economic situation, saying that the most important area that his administration will be dealing with will have to be the economy. Let's listen to what President Marcos Jr. said a while ago.
The central policy, actually, that everybody else will eventually be following will be that set out by our economic managers.
Carmina, even as the economy is showing signs of recovery from the COVID-19 pandemic, President Marcos Jr. will start his administration faced with a looming food crisis and rising fuel prices. And just now, inflation further quickened in June to 6.1% as food prices and transport costs continue to rise. The president, in his meeting yesterday at the Department of Agriculture, earlier said that ensuring access to sufficient and affordable food in the next few months in the country would be given preferential treatment under his administration. Right now, Carmina, we're still trying to get more information from Malacañang and other officials regarding the meeting, and we will be giving updates as soon as they come. That also goes for information on other schedules that the president may have for today. Carmina.
Yes, Pia, tell us more about how the information is being disseminated from the palace. How's that shaping up? I know we're just in our early days, but already you see President Marcos beginning his day early. That started on day one of his presidency. We also know that, as you reported yesterday, Press Secretary Trixie Cruz Angeles also presided over a very first press briefing. But how is the dissemination of information shaping up? To recall yesterday, Pia, and I'm sure you noticed this as well, during the press briefing, Secretary Cruz Angeles would always say, we have yet to wait for the announcement coming from the palace. I know you've covered many presidents in the past, but how is this one different from the others that you've covered in terms of information dissemination? Pia.
Right now, Carmina, we're still in a transition, and that's right. We're still having a hard time, actually, because yesterday was the first time that we were able to meet Press Secretary Trixie Cruz Angeles, and right now we're still in the process of actually building a relationship with the new members of the Presidential Communications Operations Office. Right now, all of the information that we are getting are given to us via Viber. Sometimes we are able to text officials where they give us confirmation. But like for this morning, we were only informed that the cabinet meeting will be conducted a few minutes before the cabinet meeting started. We also got this information right now, like what I said, we're still trying to get information from palace officials on how this meeting is already shaping up. But we, most of the time, we're getting information from social media. This one, video that we got, we got this from the live stream of RTVM. So right now, there's still no actually clear-cut policy on how information will be disseminated to us. But it's a good thing that, of course, these officials are actually very responsive to our questions. But we got the sense that they're still adjusting, which is very understandable as they are in the first few days of their assignment, Carmina.
All right. Also, before this incoming administration assumed office, of course, there was talk about vloggers being part of the daily press briefing. Any development on that front when the press secretary had her first press briefing yesterday? Were there vloggers there, Pia?
No developments on that front, Carmina, yesterday, but we had a briefing. Only accredited members of the Malacañang Press Corps were allowed. Actually, what happened yesterday is that they were very strict with the number of people allowed inside the press briefing room, and only those who are accredited and cleared by the Presidential Security Group were allowed to even enter the new executive building. What we know is that there's still no guidelines released by the PCOO regarding allowing members of social media users or bloggers to cover events of Malacañang. But of course, that's a different area when you talk about President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. We know that there are bloggers that are very close to him or are working with him. Like yesterday, some of the information that we got from the activities inside the palace, like for example, the social events, like the inaugural dinner, for example, we were able to get from social media. So that's a different matter. But as far as official coverages are concerned, only accredited members of the Malacañang Press Corps are allowed as of this time.
All right. Thanks a lot. Our very own Pia Gutierrez there joining us on the line. Appreciate it, Pia. Take care. Keep safe.